Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. Today we're delivering you the update which you've been waiting for so long. SpaceX teams have finally launched their integrated Starship rocket for the first time from a Texas launch site after years of development. On the 20th of April 2023, SpaceX made history again. For the first time ever, they've successfully launched their fully stacked Starship rocket. Though the launch and initial ascent stage proved nominal, but the launch ended in an explosion, which Musk terms as Rapid Unscheduled Disassembly, or RUD. According to SpaceX engineers, though the launch ended in an RUD, still it's a grand success for them, as a colossal spacecraft like Starship has successfully lifted off the ground on its first try, without doing any major damage on the pad or launch tower. So it seems that the most powerful rocket of the world put on quite a show during its debut space launch. On the 17th of April, SpaceX teams tried to carry out the launch for the first time. The date of the 17th of April, Monday, was announced just after SpaceX received their launch license from the Federal Aviation Administration, or FAA. During their first attempt, everything seemed nominal, till only 9 minutes were left to launch. Then SpaceX engineers found fault with a pressurization valve inside the Super Heavy booster. That ultimately led the team to scrub the launch. As fueling procedure was nearly complete, therefore company officials termed the launch attempt as a wet dress rehearsal and continued the countdown clock. At T-minus 40 seconds, the launch countdown clock was stopped. The company officials then announced on the webcast that they would need a minimum 48 hours time to solve the issue, and then they can go for launch. Till then, the countdown clock will be put on hold and will restart during the second launch attempt. SpaceX kept their word. Nearly 2 days after the first attempt, SpaceX had gone for the second attempt. As per reports, the aerospace company set their second launch window on Thursday, the 20th of April, opening at 8:28 a.m. Central Time to 9:30 a.m. Central Time, covering nearly 62 minutes. At 8:33 a.m. Central Time, the first ever integrated Starship rocket soared towards space with a mighty roar, lifting off from the Starbase facility at Boca Chica Beach on South Texas's Gulf Coast. Shiva Bharadwaj, space operations engineer at SpaceX, stated in the webcast that this launch is the first of many launches for transitioning Starship from the developmental into the operational program. He also stated that the main objective of this test launch is to gather as much data from the fully integrated launch to use it in improving the future Starship launches, as well as making it more reliable. As per visuals, the launch was a spectacular and surreal sight. Moreover, the 394-foot tall, shiny stainless steel Starship gleaming in the morning sun also added beauty to the sight. With its launch, Starship became the biggest and most powerful operational rocket ever built. SpaceX tweeted, "Liftoff of Starship." Later, Musk also shared the video of the launch on his Twitter page. According to the orbital flight test plan, Super Heavy was meant to come back to Earth in the Gulf of Mexico nearly 8 minutes into the flight. The second stage was also planned to fire up its 6 Raptor engines to head up to the final frontier and then head for a partial trip around our planet. Then bring it barreling back into Earth's atmosphere for a trial-by-fire re-entry, ending with a hard splashdown in the Pacific Ocean, not far from the Hawaiian island of Kauai, about 90 minutes after liftoff. Following the plan, the spacecraft lifted off safely and then continued to climb, defying its tremendous weight with the massive thrust of all Raptor engines present in the Super Heavy booster. Report says that some of the engines had turned off due to some reason, but SpaceX considered that as normal as Starship is only in developmental stage and booster deals with a lot of engines. Therefore, shutting down of some of the engines is quite probable. The flight had reached its highest point of 39 kilometers above the ground. Unfortunately, the climb didn't last long. Ship 24 was planned to get separated from the Booster 7 nearly 3 minutes after liftoff, but that never happened. Instead of separation, Ship 24 and B7 remained connected, and the stack began to tumble. Several engines were lost and ultimately faced a rapid unscheduled disassembly almost 4 minutes after launch. After the historic flight, SpaceX wrote over Twitter, "As if the flight test was not exciting enough, Starship experienced a rapid, unscheduled disassembly before stage separation." They also wrote, "Teams will continue to review data and work toward our next flight test." Kate Tice, quality system engineering manager at SpaceX, said during the webcast that, "To get this far is amazing. Anything after clearing the tower was icing on the cake." SpaceX employees, who had gathered together at SpaceX headquarters in Hawthorne, California, cheered the Starship test, though it ended with explosion, as the massive vehicle had at least carried out the first-ever liftoff. Kate had stated earlier in the webcast that, "Our main goal is to clear the pad. Every milestone beyond that is a bonus." So it seems that the test is a success, as Starship clears the pad with no issue. The company said, "With a test like this, success comes from what we learn, and today's test will help us improve Starship's reliability as SpaceX seeks to make life multiplanetary." It's quite natural that Starship, being a developmental rocket, might not be able to carry out all events according to plan, and SpaceX wasn't expecting that, which is clear from Musk's earlier statement, which states that success is not what should be expected. That would be insane. He said this in terms of orbital test flight. John Innsbrucker, SpaceX principal integration engineer, said during the launch webcast, "Now this was a development test. It's the first test flight of Starship. And the goal is to gather the data and, as we said, clear the pad and get ready to go again. So you never know exactly what's going to happen. But as we promised, excitement is guaranteed. And Starship gave us a rather spectacular end to what was truly an incredible test so far." After the launch was over, Musk congratulated his team on an exciting test launch in a tweet and said that they learned a lot for the next test launch in a few months. NASA Administrator Bill Nelson congratulated SpaceX team over Twitter. He wrote, "Every great achievement toward history has demanded some level of calculated risk, because with great risk comes great reward. Looking forward to all that SpaceX learns, to the next flight test and beyond." Nearly 5 miles away from the launch site, hundreds of onlookers cheered along the beach as they watched the historic launch. One of the onlookers said, "It's just going to be kind of amazing just to see what happens. I love the quest that the SpaceX team has, the idea of going to Mars and making us multiplanetary." The test flight comes after years of explosive tests, regulatory hurdles, and public hyping. And we can expect SpaceX to fly Starship again relatively soon. Already, the company has multiple Starship vehicles nearly ready for tests at Starbase. As per some sources, SpaceX plans to fly them pretty much as soon as they're ready. If the test campaign goes well, people could climb aboard the Starship for the first time just a few short years from now. As NASA had already selected Starship to be the first crewed lander for their Artemis Moon program, crewed missions will not be much far provided everything goes well with time. Other than that, SpaceX has two further private missions booked on Starship. One is Dear Moon from Yusaku Maezawa, and the second one is from Dennis Tito, who will fly on the other Starship Moon mission along with his wife, Akiko, and other passengers whose identities have not yet been disclosed. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.